And then the Jackie Tar hornpipe, and then the last one was the trumpet hornpipe, which was the theme tune for Captain Pugwash. Anybody remember that one? We'll not go into why it was banned off the
audition. You don't need to tell anybody who the characters were, I'm sure everybody knows.
So, moving on swiftly there. Oh, we've got a request to do for May as well, I'll remember that.
Margaret Young is asking if we can play Margaret's Waltz.
All right, okay. Well. Yep, we've got longer tonight, so we can try and fit in as many as we can. Showing off, Lynn. Carol says. Right, I'm not showing off. Who else?
You play some fresh music stuff.
Fresh. My goodness, yeah.
There's somebody else asking for Loch Maree Islands.
Yeah, okay. That was on last night's programme, that one, but we can maybe stick it in at some point. So, we had a request a few nights ago from Owen Tierney from Orkney for an Orkerian tune. It's not, well, it's about somebody from Orkney, but it's not actually an Orkerian tune, but it's called Edwin Flaws of Wire, which was also a request, so it's a double whammer, but I can't even... What was it?
Double whammy.
Oi.
Oh my gosh.
You know what I mean. So, Edwin Flaws the Wire was a request, followed by Tommy Darling. And there's a tune here that Graham Wilson sent me, the Kirkibar Ceilidh Band's Welcome to Forest. Now, the Kirkibar Ceilidh Band are from Orkney, so we'll give that a go as well, try and put them all three together. So you can let us know who it was, if you're in online, if it was yourself that told us about Edwin Flaws of Wire. So we'll give us a go. And thank you to Myra Graham for sending this on, the music. kind of went in, you're tuning the wrong time in there.
We're in half time.
So that last one was written by Graham Wilson, and I think you're in tonight, Graham. I hope you didn't hear that wee change over there. But that was Edwin Flaws of Wire, Tommy Darling, which I think is a Bobby McLeod tune, and the Kirkyvar Keeley Band's Welcome to Forest by Graham Wilson.
Anne Mitchell says, Loris, loving this, I swear. You'll have to get her dancing. You'll have to put up a video later on the page to let everybody see her dancing along.
What's all the messages before they disappear? Oh, Charlie Soane has joined. Did you get your CD today, by the way, Charlie? I sent it off to you yesterday.
Carol's asking how many outfits I have. I have a big house full of clothes.
Yeah. I've got a caravan full of them too at the same time.
I know, I have a lot of shoes. I have probably as many dresses as I do have shoes, though. And I have over 400 pairs of shoes.
Yeah.
I don't feel bad admitting that, but I'm running out of space for them, so I'm going to start selling some, I think.
I actually sleep in the caravan, and Gemma stays in the house with the shoes and all her outfits. And So, Liz Peterson's asking if you've got shoes or smocks on, Gemma.
I actually had my socks on, he knew I took my shoes off. My feet was already there.
Is that what the smell is?
Shut up!
Michael Mulford says, the pugwash story is actually... Oh, you made
pugwash.
Pugwash. Hogwash. Oh, is that not a true story, Michael? You can inform me of that at some other point. Natasha Nelson's joined. Lynn Anderson, could you play the Fiddler's Godmother? Oh, that's a nice tune. Yeah, you could do that.
It's a lovely tune. Well, somebody, Margaret asked for Margaret's Waltz earlier. Do you want to
do
that and then go into the Fiddler's Godmother?
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Or the other way around, it doesn't make any difference.
Maybe the other way, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
back.
Have you ever seen anybody get excited about a bowl before?
There's so much hair on here. I've not had like a full head of hair on my bowl for a long time. That's why Alan's growing his hair.
Yeah, she doesn't go for bald men. Oh well. So what's the request coming in? What's of people coming in, musicians and watchers? Elizabeth Stewart.
She's wanting Train Journey North.
Okay, that's for Duncan. Ivor Scully was asking for something. Hi guys, yeah. Great music. I'm really keen so many tunes. But didn't really, we've got all the music sitting here. Well, we kind of got in our head, yeah. But we've been tested a lot over this week.
I know. So, it is a really good test for us, actually, all this kind of doing requests on the spot. It is really kind of keeping us on our toes.
I've got the pile sitting there that we've already done. We did the Disney set, I think, a few days ago, or maybe
yeah,
3 days ago.
Did a few days
but ago. I'll find it anyway, and we'll maybe do it later in the programme if you stay with us, Ivor. And I hope you're well up in Shetland there. We've got a few other requests here. Graham Wilson has got more here than I've got, he says.
Any Foster and Allen tunes?
Oh yeah, well yeah, I could. And we've got one for Robert Barclay for the Alexander Brothers. We could do yeah. that together. So maybe after all these years, that's a Foster and Allen song.
Okay.
And Nobody's Child.
Yeah.
So we need you to sing up at the other end here, as loud as you can.
Thank you.
Cooper's in tonight. That was a wee bit singing for you in the middle of that one, Eileen. since you were so desperate to have me singing again.
Did I give up the accordion player? just stick to that. It's okay.
So that was After All These Years, which was sung by Foster and Allen, and Nobody's Child by, well, it wasn't by them, but Jim Reeves did it and lots of other folk, but Alexander Brothers were, that was a request from
Robert Barclay and William Skeen,
wanted Foster and Allen. So we've got lots more requests in Larousse and Cadham Boots.
Do you want to do, I don't know if Carol is in yet, actually.
I've not seen her
name. Oh, thanks very much, Ivor. Ivor says that was good fiddle improvising. I just muck about when I can.
Well, what do you want to do? Are you wanting to do... There's Swedish tunes we have to play as well for...
What kind of tunes, what tempo tunes are they? Yeah.
Okay. If any of the Norwegians are in tonight, you get your boxes on and guitars out and join us for this one. I'm not going to tell you the names of them. This is for Mae McArdle. It's three Swedish tunes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. was some Swedish tunes from May McArdle. If you have the names handy, May, on your music, you could maybe post them up so everybody knows what they are. They're great tunes anyway. So, moving on.
Sugar escapes for me. Middle of the night. Do you want to do Ian tune that I wanted to do, the Ice Cap Swing by Patty? There's a brilliant tune called Ice Cap Swing, which was written by, it was co-written by Patty Kusserup and Jeremy Rusu, and they are phenomenal players. And actually a few nights ago, I think it might have been one of the first concerts then, Daniel Robertson requested the Pig Ankle Rag. So I'll stick that at the end of the set, but we'll play these. There are a couple of kind of swingy tempo tunes, so I hope you enjoy them. Just after we came offline, then I noticed that Patty was doing a live for her house, and so I tuned in and I was like, can you play the tune? And she did, she played it within minutes of me putting it up, so I wanted to play it myself. It's a great tune. And the second one was for Daniel Robertson, that was the Pig Ankle Rag.
Yeah. Ivor says, Yon was brilliant, never heard Yon before, he says.
You're getting better at reading your Shetland dialect.
I'm trying.
Thanks very much. That's totally fun tunes to play.
There was a request last night for the Jacqueline Waltz. I'm not sure who it was, but we'll want to do that now.
Yeah.
You playing the accordion for this one?
I can if you want.
It's up to you. You play the box or the box? Okay. Somebody was asking if you would play more of the box.
Okay. Just for this one.
Here's one I made earlier.
I haven't moved it since the other night. I've never had it on.
Yeah, so this is a Jacqueline Waltz.
Oh, I'll get shifted.
By
that's
the way,
why I took this bracelet off the other night.
The name of the accordion is Crap. It doesn't have P's on the end, it's T's.
No, T's.
It's not Crap. Although a lot of people might have...
It might be when we play it. I'm just here to see.
No, it's an E.
Saying
how much you're so talented, she says.
I don't want to do that. I just work a lot of dirt. I'm good at working dirt.
I know, but you're not bad in the box.
I don't know. I've only played the box out in public a couple of times when I felt really brave at a couple of recording and fiddle clubs, just on nights where we weren't a guest artist, and I did turn my five row actually and play that a few times at Cordon and Fiddle Clubs, but really it's not something I do often enough for me to feel comfortable doing it. So
I tell you, there are a lot of my pupils that are online tonight that wish you could play like you just picking it up and then again, you know. Anyway, that was great, well done.
We have a request for Carol Floss for playing the tune that was written for Mark and, was it your dad, Carol, that it was written for? Roderick Slater's Farewell to the Malikov. It was when he retired, I think. If I mind right, for what you tell me. I don't know, my brain goes all fuzzy, so I didn't necessarily remember details completely rightly. But it's a brilliant tune that was written by Alan Nicholson. You can maybe come in and tell people on here what the tune was about. So I didn't sound like an absolute numpty saying the wrong thing. But it's a cracking tune, and its time was a couple of minutes before we came online just to kind of go over it and think, right, can we actually play this live? But
yeah, it's a very difficult tune.
It's a bit iffy in the third part, so you'll have to forgive us if it's wrong, but we'll try. We'll give it our best shot.
Yeah. See what happens. Okay, yeah, 1, 2, 3. Thank you. There's actually no bases in that tune at all. I made them all up there. Anyway, we got through it. So
no,
it's a great tune. It's a great tune. Very, very difficult though. Roderick Slater's Farewell to the Malakoff.
It's a lovely tune. It's very hard to play. But it's brilliant. It's very good. It is like a total tongue twister for the fingers, though.
Yeah. Well, keep practicing it and night, maybe.
We'll stick it in again at some point because it's cracking.
I'm gonna have a wee look for these. See if I can find these Disney waltzes for
you. They'll be in that pile.
You want to tell them about the Fife Today thing that was online?
That was fast.
Right at the back of the pile, that was... Yeah, if you look online, we were delighted that a little story has been done about our concerts, our online concerts, and it's on the Fife Today news website, isn't it? What's the guy's name? John
McInnes.
John McInnes. You'll have seen him coming in online. He's very kindly put the story together for us. And he got it printed. So thanks very much, John.
Yes, thank you.
So if you have a look on the Fife Today website, you'll see that. So this is a request for Ivor Scully up in Shetland. A dream is a wish your heart makes. Chim chimmery. Someday my prince will come. Has he come yet?
I don't know.
And when you wish upon a star. So. We did this, I think, last weekend or at the beginning of the week, but we'll play it again. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. for Ivor Scully. I hope you enjoyed that, Ivor. That's off our CD. Back on track, that one's on. So, what else is there? Lots of messages in, isn't there? More Agad and Vegan.
Peter says, it's time you got a TV slot for this.
Well, you can get it on your telly if you do a feed to the television. You know, I saw somebody actually sent me a message today with up on their television.
Yeah, somebody, Daniel Robertson had it up on his newsfeed as well. It was plugged into his TV too.
Yeah. So, the other ones here are all waltzes. Oh, here's another tune here. It's a 2-4.
Ivor Scully, thanks for that beautiful tune, so well played. Some pretty obscure keys as well. Yeah, that's my fault. They sound better than the flat keys.
So, we'll do this next tune, George Chalmers, which is for Graham Wilson. It's written by Al Waters, who was a founder member of the Highland Accordion Fiddle Club. So this is for Graham, and we'll put it with another 2-4 maybe. Let's do...
You can decide at the time.
Major Manson of Clashing Crucial. I'm trying to get off my...
That's a big title.
It is. Major Manson of Clashing
Crucial. I'm impressed.
Clashing Crucial.
Clashing Crucial. What on earth is that?
No idea.
I was walking the out.
Thank you. so there are loads of information coming in about these tunes we've just played. If you scroll back there, you'll get what Graham said. George Chammers, which was the first tune.
Yes.
George was an undertaker who lived near Inverness and was a great follower of the Dingwall Club as well as the Highland Club. So that was Graham Wilson that sent down that one. And Dave Ritchie from Dunfermline came in saying Clash and Crucial is on the west coast. I think there's a statue there. Gary Innes was talking about it the other week on the floor. So.
I must have missed him speaking at that point.
Yeah. And we did Pumpkin's Fancy, which was a reel at the end there. I noticed Graham Wells has joined us. He's a piper from Haddington Pipe Band. So that one is a wee tune just for you, Graham. I'm sure you know it well, the Pumpkin's Fancy. So, I've got a request here for Myra Graham, which we've been meaning to do. So, this is one of Myra Graham's favourite tunes. Myra follows us after we've watched the concerts, because she's not on Facebook, which her and her husband Jim, they watch every single concert after it's been on, and they love them, so...
People that aren't on Facebook can still watch the videos, it's just that I don't think they can watch them live when they're going out. If I'm wrong on that, then you can maybe let me know and then I can let other people know. But you can certainly tune in afterwards. For anybody that's on or off Facebook, they can watch it on the replays.
Good. And this is a tune called The Ash Grove. It's actually a version of this tune that Jimmy Shand recorded. And it was on, he recorded it on Beltona, apparently. I would think that would be on a vinyl, probably. Followed by Jenny Jones. The Ash Grove is written by Sandy Tulloch, who was a great friend of Jimmy Shand. He was from Dundee and he was an eye surgeon. I remember Sandy, he used to come to Newborough Curry Fiddle Club and I used to go as a young lad there. So, The Ash Grove and Jenny Jones.
Thank you.
So you would do a waltz country dance to that one. That's going to back a long time now to for these tunes. But the Ashgrove and Jenny Jones. And that's from Myra and Jim Green. So, moving on.
There's Anona's requested the Bonalas upon the Court. And Dave Millinson says, your repertoire is so vast, how about a set of Irish polkas?
My goodness. Is Manus here? If Manus McGuire was here, he would rattle them off.
You want to do some Irish band dances?
Oh yeah, the ones off Full Tilt. Yeah, do them.
Now, if I can remember the names of them. Bella de Ball is one of them.
Yeah.
Chaffpool Post is the first one, and the second one is called Bell of the Ball.
Well done, you. Ha! It's not like you to remember.
I know!
The keys are there.
I just had to imagine Manus' voice, because it's him that introduces that set. So I just had to imagine what it was that he said about them, and then I was like, yeah, okay, I can manage.
What keys are there?
G and...
And then A and D, is it?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So, one, two, three, four.
She's the box player from Ceilidh, she comes to Ceilidh, remember, you know,
yes.
Her and her brother. I hope you're well, Lauren, and still getting a few tunes. Lauren and her brother are excellent players. Is it Sean and Hegarty, I think? Lauren and Sean, so.
There's Kenny Gillis and Potting Along.
Yeah, we can do that one. That's a pipe jig. Any more pipe jigs you want to throw at us? We're still trying to find the juggernaut.
Oh, that's good. Graham Wilson says, my good pal Don Gaynor in Oklahoma asked me to say hi. He can't send messages. Yeah, I think we'd had a conversation about that, about I have no idea how to fix that problem either for him. So there's a few people that have said that they've struggled to be able to comment on the videos, and I'm not quite sure what lets you or stops you from being able to do it. I know that I had a problem with it on the iPad one day, but I managed to get it on the computer, no problem. So, I don't know.
This set's actually on Making Tracks album, which you can still get on a download. We don't have any hard copies left of that album, but it's Kenny Gillis of Floating Along, Jiggy Swerves, Glasgow City Police Pipers, and Troy's Wedding. They're all pipe jigs, so I hope you enjoy it. Let's get 1, 2, 3, 4.
last one.
I know.
I kind of do that bit without actually moving. Kind of sit still when I play it.
Robert Barclay also requested a set of the first, well, it wasn't in the first CD, but the In Full Swing CD. It's probably maybe the first one that he's got. That was recorded back in 2000. So we'll do a set off of that for Robert. And it's the very first set on the album. It's a set of Burns marches. Don't ask me what the names of them are. I'm sure you'll be able to tell me because they're all popular tunes. So. So like and share the page as much as you can. We want more people to know. We've got more followers today, which is great. We're nearly at the 1,000 mark now, which is amazing.
We have people in the group.
Yeah, that's more good. More new people, and they're coming in from all over the world, which is amazing. So we always get the odd. And there was people in, somebody in from Texas last night,
yeah.
And somebody from Australia.
Yeah.
And Canada.
San Francisco.
Yeah, in San Francisco.
Oklahoma.
Yeah, so it's fantastic. We're reaching out to the whole world, which is amazing. And I hope we're still keeping you smiling at your end.
I know, hopefully nobody's bored of us yet.
We're smiling plenty, but you might not be.
Sometimes we look awful grumpy when we're playing. We try not to, but...
That's when
we're concentrating really hard, we kind of look grumpy.
That's when the camera's off. As soon as the camera's off, Gemma gives me a thump, you know?
No, I do not!
You got that note wrong.
Usually after we come off, then I spend the next 20 minutes ignoring you while I kind of try and look through the comments to see if I've missed anybody's tune requests so that we can stick them in. And also, then we generally get something to eat.
There we go. There's some Nancy Iverson. You have some very loyal San Francisco watchers and listeners.
Oh.
Excellent.
Yeah, Nancy's been in every concert, actually, I think.
Yeah, that's amazing. Brilliant.
It's amazing to, I suppose, for ways that we've never done anything like this before, and I suppose it's really just circumstance that's led us here, but actually we're thoroughly enjoying it.
Yeah.
And it's lovely that everybody keeps coming back and wants to hear more of us, that they're no sick of us yet.
Yeah.
They might be if we keep yarning.
Yeah, we're going to the music. That's off the In Full Swing album, 7th Marches. So that was for Robert.
There's been a lot of comments on this. I'm missing them as they're going by. They're flicking by that fast.
Yeah, we'll have to go back and see what we can find any.
I know, if we do miss anybody's request, so please just post it again and put it in capitals and then I'll definitely see it.
But our music again tonight, guys, Evelyn Scobie. Graham Wilson, he's a song.
Madrid Young's wanting a set for an Eva 3 step.
Okay.
Dave Collins and Troy's wedding just reminded me of Mouth and Beak.
Okay.
Leaving Glenochet and Banal Highlanders.
I know the Banal Highlanders. I saw a great version of Leaving Glenochet on Michael Garvin's live video. I think that was yesterday. If you look up Michael, he made a great job of it. It's not a tune that I play, but we'll have to get the music. Anything else? Accordions Unlimited. Never heard that one, Graham. You'll have to send me the music for that one.
Mary says, how could we ever get... Oh, it's got smooth. How could we ever get bored of you two? You're totally brilliant. I want you to come down and play for our birthdays and maybe we can have a tune or two. That would be great.
Excellent. Right, we've got a few requests here.
Johnny Stenhouse says, I thought the keys were odd, but my guitar was out of tune. No, it's maybe the box. I'm tuned to the accordion.
There was a request the other night for Agnes Waltz. We'll play that just now. I'm not sure who that was for. The June Clover Waltz we played last night was for Ian Thau. Last night I couldn't remember who it was for, but he came in today and thanked us for playing it. So that was for Ian Thau. So we'll play the Agnes Waltz just now.
Thank you.
tune that. That's going back a long time. The Agnes Waltz.
Very pretty.
I noticed somebody asking for Honeymoon Harry. I've got the music for that in my folders there, but I'll maybe rake it out for tomorrow night.
Yeah, you can do that tomorrow.
We can do that one tomorrow.
I'll go back through the comments after we finish tonight, and I will make sure I write down everything everybody's asking for, because I've pages and pages of requests written down with Fox names next to it, and then I have to kind of go through them all and see if there's any duplicates, because then we can let you all know that there's more than one person asking for it at a time. The other person that came in last night, I was delighted to get a pretty message after we came offline, was Calvin Volrath from Canada. He had come online and heard Brian Morrison's tune and had sent me a message asking what was that composed it and what the name of the tune was. I sent him a message back and I says, oh well, I quite often play some of Calvin's tunes, so I will put this the Laverne Hummel special at the end of a set with either my tunes, which I wrote, oh, I must have been about 15 or 16 years old, so that was a while ago, it wasn't yesterday. And it was written after a night I was playing the Love Shack with my dad, and we were sitting in the back of the Love Shack van on the way home, and I was working at Shetland Fudge Shop at the time, and I'd said something daft to Roy Tate, better known as Tato, and I said something really daft to him about why he said, he asked a question about chocolate, and I says, oh, it's awful, like it's sentimental or something like that. So he ended up telling me I had to write a tune called Tato's Sentimental Fudge. So the tune was written, and I don't think he's ever heard it actually, but this is Tato's Sentimental Fudge, and then into a lovely tune written by Calvin Volrath called the Laverne Hummel Special.
G
and A. G and A, yeah. The second pair of the G one goes to starts on the C or something.
Okay.
Thank you.
that was Tato's sentimental fudge and the Laverne Hummel special.
Brilliant. Great tunes. Really good tunes. Somebody wanted 6-8 marches for a Eva 3 step, yeah, didn't they? I can't remember who it was. But,
Or if you're not, they like reels.
That's right, yeah, they do. In fact, it was Eileen Allen. If you're in tonight, Eileen, I got your message. She sent me a message of her them watching the on the television in their living room.
Oh, very good.
So we've made it to television.
Excellent.
Well, not through the proper channels, but... The Eva Three Step's a bit like the national dance in Orkney, as same as what the Boston Two Step is in Shetland, so we'll play some tunes for that.
Duke of Perth, Irish Reel, the girl with the blue dress on.
We could put the Duke of Perth for the LaRousse and the Karen Woods,
okay,
because that was one earlier as well. So
yeah,
but we'll do that Eva Three Step and then we'll do some, you want some 6-8s and then a Terry one.
I don't mind, I'm happy to do
anything. Somebody asked for this Calvin there, look, he's just joined.
Calvin's
you
just joined.
You play it again.
Calvin, I just played your tune there.
Just do it again.
Sorry.
Just do it again.
I'll do a pretty bit of it again, then you can hear it. But you'll be able to get it on the catch-up afterwards. I just played a tune of my own, Tato's Sentimental Fudge, and then finished off with the Laverne Hummel special song. that's a shame. I should have waited another 5 minutes and then played it.
Just play this one again.
Okay.
You've made it to telly in Maidenhead. What's that?
Oh, that's Chris.
Oh, Maidenhead 2.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Chris. Sorry, that's not Calvin. Chris Oxtoby. Excellent, that's good.
Calvin says yeehaw. I hope I played you right. I don't know. I might have just made half it up, but no, I think that's the way I learned it.
So somebody wanted the Banal Highlanders, and somebody last night asked for Dundee City Police Pipe Band. For a request for a friend of theirs, it's in the pipe band in Dundee, so we will play them for an Eva 3 step, and maybe into a reel. And if you have any more requests, keep them coming.
Thank you.
blast from the past. The past, the last one then. The blast. I can't get my words right.
Blast from the past. Blast.
Yeah. So that was the Banal Highlanders, Dundee City Police Pipe Band. I can't remember the reels, the names of the reels. But anyway, that's for the Orcadians for an Eva 3-step. So, what's all the messages saying?
I'll have to go back a few. Watching on the TV tonight, that's Jean Anderson.
Okay.
Adeline Christie Johnson. Could you play any of Calvin Volrath's waltzes? I spoke to him on the phone yesterday. I might be able to stick one in later on. If not tonight, then it will be I'll stick one in the Morden's programme. Yeah. Give Alan a chance to, to kind of go.
Yeah, the music from Canada is all new to me since I met Gemma, so it's great music, it's brilliant.
Oh, you need to, Calvin, Graham was asking Calvin if he's done a live, like any of the live concerts yet. Calvin has said that he's not done one before, but he's thinking he will, but yeah, you need to.
We could bring him in live and play with us at the same time. We could work that out.
Do a big live feed across the pond.
Yeah. Want to do this request? We've got this to do for Joe Bruce. And you can see it.
Are you sticking it with that one too?
Yeah. Do you know who that's for?
Yeah, that's for Duncan McKinnon.
Oh, is that the one for Duncan? Yeah. Right, okay. So you can tell them the names.
Well, one is called Aileen Alana, and the other one is Slivenaman, I think. I don't know if that's the right pronunciation, so please don't shoot me.
That's for Joe Bruce, that last one. So, and the first one's for Duncan
McKinnon.
I think it's box player Duncan McKinnon. I think so.
Thank you.
beautiful tunes, aren't they? Lovely tunes.
I loved the last tune. I forgot that that's what that tune was until we started playing it. But it's a beautiful tune, that.
We're needing music for Montgomery's Rant, if anybody has it and can send it to us. Maybe that's a tune that you've got, Dave Ritchie, from Dunfermline. If you have a look in your music, it's called Montgomery's Rant. That's one we're needing.
Jamie Rogers is asking if we can do a shout-out to Tracy Hillhouse. She's just listening and just learning the box.
Good. So. Oh, well, good luck with learning the box, Tracy. It's not an easy instrument, but I'm sure you're doing well, so stick in. Else we got? We had a few other requests, didn't we, for the Duke of Perth and
yes.
Warris.
And the kind of boots.
Yeah, so we'll do them just now. 2, 3. Scandali Super 6 as well, there are not many of them going around.
Nice,
so that's an older one too. So
Liz Peterson asking if we know we're looking for a partner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll do that one. It's a two-step. Thank you. missing you there.
I know, I was paying attention.
Good. Graham Wilson says, bought a Super 6 two or three years ago. Love playing it, but it's getting sore. Playing it for a long now. What, the box is getting sore, or you are, Graham? It's a great box, the Skandalia. I mean, they're heavy boxes, right enough. And Brian Forrest, he plays second accordion with Neil Hardy's band, which I'm sure a lot of you have heard of. Patty's joined us.
Oh, yeah. I played Ice Cap Swing earlier on, Patty. I hope you don't mind. I played it in a set with the tune The Pig Ankle Rag. Somebody had requested, so you'll be able to see it on the catch-up if you feel it tuning in.
There's a tune that we got asked for last weekend by Angus McKinley. He called it The Witch's Waltz, but it was written, it's he meant for you, Fiddle Witch.
Oh, right, okay. Yes.
Gemma's Waltz.
Yeah,
you couldn't really throw that in. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there's a tune I wrote for Gemma, it's called Gemma's Waltz.
Jumping bars, is that because someone's joining in? It could be. It could also be the internet being patchy. It decides to do things like that sometimes here.
Yeah.
I'm trying to head out. I'm waiting on an Amazon delivery for a separate webcam so I can hardwire everything into the computer. So hopefully that'll get rid of any of the technical gremlins that's going through our system, but
yeah, we get a few from time to time. But anyway, we've got some more comments coming in. Patty says, beautiful tune. Oh, thank you, that's nice. What else have we got? Shirley McNally. Neely, I keep saying Neely.
You did that the other night too. It's alright, Alan can't read, it's okay. She's went in Bonnie Kirkle Bay.
Is that the march? Day, 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 dum, dum, dum. We can do that with Barney Yard's Adele Cattie, because that was a...
Yes, somebody asked for that.
That was for William Skeen. He wanted the Barney Yard's Adele Cattie, so...
Okay. You going to sing it?
Nope. Whiskey, but yeah. It's the Glendarool Highlanders, it's the pipe version of that tune, so that's what we played. So Vigard Hansen from Norway's joined us. We should maybe play. Somebody asked for Borgie's Polka, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I could remember. That one, you were singing it all day
last
week.
I know I was. May was in for a lesson before all of this kind of craziness happened, so she was here and I was busy footing about with something on the computer, and I had headphones on, but it still managed to get through to my brain this this lovely pretty tune, and it went through my head the whole time for about the next week after that. It was great. Try some of that.
It's underneath your petticoat in a purple book there.
I never thought you'd ever say that sentence. Hang on. Okay.
It's Ian Holmes' book. It's down there somewhere, if you can see it.
Yep, it's here.
Have you got it?
Yep.
This is a... It's not really
it's
a Scandinavian...
Book, actually.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's not really a Scandinavian tune, but it's written in the Scandinavian style. So if you've got the box handy, Vigga, you can play along with us. That would be great. If I can find what page it's on, you can yatter away and everything.
Yatter?
Yeah.
What's a yatter when it's at home?
A yatter's. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Something that you're good at.
Yeah, I'm known as quite a talker, I think. When my speech is good, it's fine.
There it is, there it is. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ian Holmes that wrote that tune, it's great, in the Scandinavian style, so. So, any more requests? We've got more coming in. Jockey Hazel Dean. There's also...
Father of the Choir. That's a lovely tune as well.
You know that one?
Yeah, but I don't know if I could mind.
Is that that tune?
No, that's Music at Speed.
Oh, is it? Right.
But we could play that one. We've not done any slow airs tonight.
No. Somebody was wanting a song as well.
Oh. Do you want to do...
They haven't done Into Each Life for a while. Maybe
no.
I were still on.
I also have Tennessee Waltz or something like that.
What key's that in? No, oh, give me another pen and boost up.
Yeah, no, I think. Yeah, I will.
Yeah. Okay.
I just waltz in Alan had no idea what was happening yonder in the middle.
No, just, I was getting the eyebrows and the nods, but I'm thinking, right, is that a key? Is that a key change, or is it me to play, or is it the flags aren't working? I'm gonna have to get wee flags that pop out for the side of your head change. Move up a key.
Like, I don't know, I'll have to have a foot pedal that puts us some sort of thing up that says, no!
There was also a request from William Skeen the other night for the Bonnie Wells Aweary. I had to look it up. I remember the waltz, but I just, the tune, had, I played it years ago, so I'll give that a wee bash, I think. And then also Michael Mulford asked for The Road and the Miles to Dundee. It was in his set from the old Dundee set last night, so we'll stick that in. And maybe some other sing-along. Somebody asked for Stornoway, so what about we sing-along then, eh?
Yeah.
Thank you. set full of requests for a lot of people there. Tracy Hill House came in with Lochranich. We didn't play that one. Miscovered Mountains, we finished that set with that one. And Morrigan and Vegan was the second last tune. Somebody asked for Jockey Hazel Dean earlier, we put that in too. And also the Road and the Miles to Dundee for Michael Mulford. And also, I think we started with, where did we start with that?
Song? Can't remember the name of that one.
The Bunny Wells the Weary, that was for William Skeen.
Alessandra's online as well.
From Italy.
Alessandra kindly did my bows for me, and she does an amazing job. I haven't lost one hair. It's so good. It's been so long since I had any bows into her. I suppose my health has not been keeping that great, so I've not really been out playing an awful lot. And so I've really left it to the point where all my bows died before I got any of them rehaired. So she very kindly did them a double quick time and got them back to me today. So they're brilliant.
She plays some Italian tunes for them. We've got loads of requests in as well.
There's a request for Shetland Reels.
Okay.
So I could maybe do the Grosser and
Wax of Burden's nothing to do with tablets for putting you to go to the toilet.
No. That wouldn't be handy at the moment, seeing as none of the supermarkets has any toilet roll. No. Bad idea. That's not what the tune is about.
No.
Okay, set the reels.
Thank you. start tuning her out. And then you start it again.
I thought I would just keep you on your toes.
Oh well, I'm still on my bum. Well done.
Alessandra, I noticed her comment in there saying that she's glad I like them. If anybody needs their bows rehaired, please send them to Alessandra because she is fantastic at what she does. She really is the best bow rehairer I've ever had my bows to. So.
Good.
I'm a very loyal customer. when I get to the point of sending my bows, that's the only person I will send them to. The second tune, Di is asking what the name of the second tune is, Cad. That's the one, I can never mind if it's Hjartefjord or Hjartefeld. I think it's Hjartefjord. I'm pretty sure that Hjartefeld is a tune that was written by Margaret Robertson. But yeah, it's got a Hjarte something. it's got a funny name. I think pretty sure that's a Tom Anderson tune as well as the Grosser. So.
Well, it's coming near the end of the evening.
I know, it's 28 minutes past 10 already.
2.5 hours has went in like that. It's just amazing, isn't it?
I know, it really does feel like it's only been 10 minutes.
Yeah, it always
probably
does.
Probably feels like a lot longer for everybody else that's watching us. They've probably fed up anyways by now.
We hope you've enjoyed the concert. We've certainly enjoyed playing for you. It's been great fun. And it's great to see all these people coming in and joining us. New people again. Joining up all the time, which is great. So like and share this as much as you can. Do watch parties, everything that you can to promote this, because it really is becoming popular, and we want
it's
to try.
It's keeping us going as well.
Keep us going as well.
We're sitting at, I suppose today we had a lot of schoolwork to do with the bairns, so we had to do that rather as well as looking through music and printing things off and everything else. So we were kind of. And I ironed her backdrop, not that you would be able to tell.
She ironed the wall. She does funny things sometimes, you know. And ironing the wall. You know. I had to hold the wall up while she ironed it.
I know, you had to have it steady.
Oh dear.
But we have a blast doing these concerts, and we're just going to, I think, we'll not do an afternoon one tomorrow,
we'll just do the night thing.
When we started last week, we did do a Saturday afternoon because we were so excited and wanted to do another concert. But we'll just stick to doing nightly concerts at 8 o'clock UK time for anybody that does want to tune in. And hopefully we'll see you all tomorrow.
We'll finish with a set of jigs, so maybe some reels as well. We'll see what happens. So.
Excellent.
being stuck though. We stuck that last tune in for Billy Peace at the end there, the Dalby Kirk trio. That was one of my own tunes, but I sent the music to Billy for that tune about a month ago. So, anyway, thanks very much, folks. If you've really enjoyed the concert that much and you would like to make a donation, that is absolutely amazing, but don't feel you have to.
Yes.
Please don't feel you have to. The donations so far have been amazing, really.
Yes, and anybody that does donate, we will send the 30% discount. We've just updated all the stock, so we know exactly what we have. And so, please, if you do donate, bear with us, because I'm trying to get around everybody as fast as I can. The link is either pinned down below, it might not be there anymore, or it's also in the description for the videos. So anybody that hasn't done so, then feel free.
Yeah. And thanks very much for joining us, and we'll be back tomorrow night at 8, maybe for about the same length of time.
Yeah, about 2.5 hours.
Roughly.
If you can bear this for that long,
you never know, it might go on a bit longer. We'll just see what happens. See what happens in the spur of the moment. But stay safe, everybody, and
take care.
Stay in the house. Don't go out unless you really, really need to. And we'll see you tomorrow. Cheers.